Returning to the WWC's overall requirements for outcome measures, the third requirement is that they must avoid overalignment with the intervention or comparison group. What do we mean by overalignment? Overalignment occurs when a study closely tailors a measure to a condition, or the measure repeats some aspects of a condition. If a study closely aligns or tailors outcome measures to the intervention, the study findings may not accurately indicate the effect of the intervention. Let's talk through an example. Consider a study in which intervention group students read certain passages, but comparison group students do not read those passages. The outcome measure for the study is a test that includes the reading passages used in the intervention group. This does not provide a fair test of the intervention because the students in the intervention group have an advantage. Even if the intervention has no effect on reading ability, intervention group students might score better than the comparison group students simply because the intervention group students are familiar with the passages on the test. A comparison of outcomes between the intervention and comparison groups may provide an unrealistically favorable assessment of the effect of the intervention. If a study uses an overaligned outcome measure, the WWC will rate all analyses that use the measure does not meet WWC group design standards. This rule does not apply if material covered by an outcome measure must be explicitly taught. For example, reciting the alphabet requires being taught the alphabet. The WWC would not consider this measure overaligned in situations where teaching young children to recite the alphabet is a developmentally appropriate component of the intervention. We've discussed three of the four review requirements for outcome measures: validity, reliability, and no overalignment. The fourth requirement is that the study must collect the outcome measure in the same manner for the intervention and comparison groups to ensure that post-intervention differences between groups result from the intervention and not from data collection differences. If the mode of data collection differs between groups, then the difference in the observed outcome between the intervention and comparison groups may be attributable to something related to the outcome measure itself and not just to the intervention. Suppose a study examines the effects of a dropout prevention program and uses student attendance as the outcome measure. For the intervention group, students self-report their attendance rates on surveys. For the comparison group, the study obtains student attendance data from school administrative records. Students in the intervention condition may report attendance rates much higher than the rates would appear in administrative records. If so, differences in data collection mode could cause an observed effect on attendance, apart from any effect of the intervention. If a study collects outcome measures differently by condition, the WWC rates the analyses does not meet WWC group design standards. The WWC considers several types of issues when deciding if the data collection differed between groups. The first issue is differences in the mode of data collection, as in the example in which the researchers used survey data in one condition and administrative data in the other. Another issue is differences in the timing of data collection. If the study measured outcomes at different points in time, the additional time in one condition might influence the results. Differences in the personnel involved in test administration and differences in the procedures used to construct scores could also influence the results. Each of these examples leads us to question whether the estimated impacts are due to the intervention or to differences in the measurement of the outcomes. Studies may not discuss these aspects of outcome measurement directly. If there is nothing to suggest a difference, then the WWC assumes the processes were the same across groups. Researchers may choose to impute missing data, replacing the unobserved data in some way. Previous modules have discussed how the WWC addresses missing and imputed data when calculating attrition and assessing baseline equivalence. As noted in the baseline equivalence, which is Module 3, Only randomized control trials with low attrition can meet WWC group design standards when there are any imputed outcome data in the analytic sample. Any other analyses with imputed outcome data in the analytic sample receive the Does Not Meet WWC Group Design Standards rating.